been for our 8-day champion, Ray Lalonde. As one of 7 siblings, he certainly has to be getting more attention than usual at family gatherings. And with over $200,000 in winnings, perhaps their expectations of gifts have gone up as well. But despite those response, just when he needed it. Today, his new challengers are Maggie and Scott. Welcome and good luck. Here are the categories in the Jeopardy round. Let's get to them. We start with Espionage Glossary. Then, rhyming responses. It's a world of beers. We have historical figures on film, fiction, and finally, economy of movement. What do you think, Ray? Where do we start?
Historical figures on film for 600, please.
2022. Tom Hanks as this manager of Elvis with a shadowy past. Scott.
Who is Colonel Tom Parker?
That's right.
Let's take 800 historical figures.
2010. Him as George VI in The King's Speech. Scott.
Who is Firth?
Yes, Colin Firth.
Let's take 1,000 historical figures.
2021. Her as Diana, spending Christmas with the in-laws. Maggie.
Who is Kristen Stewart?
Yes.
I'll do fiction for 800.
His The World According to Garp and The Cider House Rules were both made into movies. Scott.
Who is McCourt?
No. Ray.
Who's Irving?
John Irving is correct.
Fiction for 1,000, please.
This author of Waiting to Exhale says, I write about what breaks my heart, what I don't understand, and what I wish I could change. Maggie.
Who is Macmillan?
Another 1,000 for you, yes.
Fiction for 600.
From chapter 1 of this classic, on a bright May morning in 1888, John, Lord Greystoke, and Lady Alice sailed from Dover. Scott.
What is Tarzan?
Yes, Tarzan of the Apes.
Let's take rhyming responses for 8.
To confiscate by force, and to goad, or to back home your hair a bit. That would be to seize and to tease. Scott?
Let's take rhyming for 600.
A response, well, other than on Jeopardy, and a terpsichorean. Ray?
What is an answer and a dancer?
Right.
Rhyming responses for 1,000, please.
Arriving before the expected time, and in a rotten, irritable mood. Scott?
What is early and surly?
Right, for 1,000.
Let's take rhyming for 4.
To shred cheese and ocho, translated from Spanish. Scott.
What is 8 and great?
Yes.
Let's take fiction for 4.
In Ruth Ware's thriller, The Woman in Cabin 10, the cabin isn't in the woods, but on one of these. Maggie.
What's a boat?
Yeah, it's on a cruise ship.
I will do World of Beers for 600.
Gold Star and Maccabi are beers from this nation. Maggie.
What is Israel?
That's right.
World of Beers 8.
Trappist monks in this small European country make Chimay and use the income to support their charitable works. Ray.
What is Belgium?
You got it.
World of Beers for 1,000.
First brewed in 1842, Pilsner Urquell from this Central European Republic is based on a beer first made in the Middle Ages. Ray.
Was Austria?
No. Maggie.
What is the Czech Republic?
That's the Republic. You got it.
Economy of movement, 600.
Doc, are you telling me that you built a time machine out of a this, and you can rent a replica for $2,000 a day? Scott.
What is a DeLorean?
A DeLorean is correct. That's a pretty good price. You have $3,200. You're in second place, and we're going to take a quick break. We'll come back in just a moment. As a math and computer science teacher from Lincoln, Nebraska. And Scott, when you and your spouse got married, you had a wedding cake that I think will go over very well with a Jeopardy audience. Tell us about it.
Yeah, so as a lifelong lover of puzzles, I decided to make my groom's cake into an actual crossword puzzle. So it was themed after different cakes. So it had SpongeBob for sponge cake and carrot top. And then all of the guests got the puzzle and they got to check their answers against the cake.
I've never eaten a crossword puzzle I've solved. That sounds fantastic. Yep. Maggie Frank Hsu is a writer from San Diego. And you're joining us today on Jeopardy, but this is not the first time you auditioned for the show, right?
Yep, that's right. I auditioned almost 20 years ago in person in New York, and I did pretty good, and they asked me to come back the next day, and I just chickened out, and I didn't ever go back, and I've been trying to get back on the show ever since.
You were just too nervous.
I was too nervous, and yeah, so.
You've had 15 or 20 years to get the nerves out.
Yeah.
Are you feeling good?
Yeah, I know a lot more than I did back then, so.
You did the right thing. You saved your eligibility. Ray Lalonde is a scenic artist from Toronto, Canada. You told us recently about a mural you once painted for your daughter's school play. That ties into one of your most treasured possessions, right?
Yeah, I have a huge handmade card from all the children who were in the play, and they signed their names as themselves and their characters. It was like Tommy, the Mad Hatter. Thank you, and it was just lovely. Speaking of gratitude, I mean, I wanted to say something while I'm up here, still up here, to the contestant crew here who's been the nicest, most patient, kindest people in the world, and just made this experience a joy.
That's fantastic. We want everyone to have a good time on Jeopardy. I'm glad it's working. And apparently, if you win 8 times, you have a really good time. Meg, you have control of the board right now. Scott, where would you like to go?
Let's go economy for 8.
This airline can take you first class.
Even though it's a
pass from New York to London for about $6,500. A trip on the same brand Galactic is more. Scott.
What is Virgin?
Yes, Virgin Atlantic.
Economy for 1,000.
In 2008, this alphanumeric Cunard ship set out with its last passengers, with some berths going for more than $40,000. Maggie.
What is Queen Mary 2?
No. Scott.
What is the QE2?
Elizabeth, yes, that's correct.
Economy for 4.
A train still runs under the name Venice Simplon This, but Istanbul to Paris costs $20,000 for a twin cabin? That's murder. Maggie.
What is the Orient Express?
Yes.
World of Beers 400.
Sing Beer from Thailand uses a mystical one of these beasts on its label. Maggie.
What's a tiger?
No. Ray.
What is a dragon?
Also incorrect. Scott? It's gonna try.
Is a Yeti?
No, I'm sorry. I'd like to drink Yeti beer. No harm, no foul. It's actually a lion. Maggie?
Okay. Historical figures, 400.
2008. Him as slain San Franciscan leader Harvey Milk. Scott.
Who is Penn?
That's right, Sean Penn.
Historical for 2.
2018. Felicity Jones as this groundbreaking attorney in On the Basis of Sex. Maggie.
Who is Ruth Bader Ginsburg?
That's right.
Espionage Glossary 800.
Also a word for 0, it's a method spies use to disguise messages by shuffling letters around. Scott.
What is cipher?
Yes.
Espionage for 6.
This mortal term refers to the prearranged location spies use to relay information without meeting. Maggie.
What's a dead drop?
That's it.
Espionage 1000.
The use of sexual wiles in espionage is called this, which sounds like it would work against Winnie the Pooh. Hey.
What is a honey trap?
That's it.
Espionage Clause 3 for 400, please.
As you might expect, that's the Daily Double. Not a lot of places left where it could be. You're in third place, Ray.
It seems like the time for a true Daily Double.
All right. If correct, you will still be in third place, but a lot closer. Here's your clue. John le Carré popularized this word in a 1974 novel he defined it as an agent so-called because he knows the...
What is a bull?
Yes, you double up to $3,600. 5 clues remain.
Glossary for 200, please.
003, here's your this, a compilation of documents about your next target. The steel one was in the news in 2017. Ray.
Was it dossier?
Yes.
Rhyming responses for 200, please.
A bird that can talk and a unit of gold fineness. Scott.
What is a parrot and a carrot?
That's right.
Fiction for 2.
Written under the V.C. Andrews name, recent prequels to her best-selling series include Beneath the This and Out of the This. Maggie.
What is Flowers in the Attic?
No. Ray.
What is Attic?
Yes, Beneath the Attic. Select again, Ray.
World of Beers 200.
Refreshing like a milkshake, this Irish beer nicknamed the Black Stuff is known for its unique texture. Maggie.
What is Guinness?
That's right. And the final clue, an economy of movement. The Smithsonian exhibited a ticket costing a pricey 1,000 Reichsmarks for the 1937 last flight of this transport. Ray.
What is the Hindenburg?
That's...